Right.
You know, and so I, you know, believe there's definitely a role for them to help out. I just, you know, I wonder if allowing them to pull anybody over, having complete police powers is appropriate. Maybe this isn't the time to continue that conversation, given the empty dock that we have coming up, but, you know, something that I think is worthwhile and to look into. So I know John wants to ITL this bill. It's probably not going to go anywhere if we were able to pass it from the subcommittee. But John did mention, you know, a ride-along for the two of us to sign up with the liquor enforcement, just to kind of get a feel for why.
I would totally do that.
I would do that, too. So
the hard part is
I would wait and hear how it goes.
the hard part is you know, picking. You really want to carefully choose a place so that there might be something actually going on.
Right.
You know, I imagine that there's a lot of downtime if you're a liquor enforcer in a sort of general location where you want to pick a place like Durham or someplace where there's a significant amount of potential activity.
Right. So I'd still be open to that. You know, maybe that's something you can put on hold for the time being, and then maybe set something up with them. But and then, you know, see where it goes. Because I am interested to see, because obviously don't know every single thing that goes into each one of their daily responsibilities, and if there is compelling reasons to why they need full enforcement ability, then, you know, I'm open to that. So.
Yeah, to me, whether it makes sense to have them be have all of the responsibilities and control that a regular police officer has. So theoretically, they can charge you with any crime.
Right.
Not just crimes from Title 13. And that's, I don't know.
It seems to me, I mean, this instance in which this young woman was charged seems a bit outrageous. I imagine that if we looked at a lot of the situations, there would be several that would seem questionable. Or, you know, does the punishment not necessarily fit the crime? And yet, I can see a situation in which liquor enforcement person could be in a situation where they're dealing with somebody who's had too much to drink, and there are lots of possibilities of behavior that can come out of that.
Right.
And if they don't have the ability to contain that situation by having the authority necessary, that could be a real problem for them in terms of safety. So we haven't heard lots of complaints about the authority mission enforcers. So, you know, unless we can be presented with a long list of these are the problems, I think it doesn't need changing at this point.
In the real issue for that particular circumstance was the applicability of the law to what happened.
Right.
The idea that it was legally purchased alcohol placed in the car by someone over 21.
Right.
And the enforcement officer chose to take an action that he was legally allowed to take because of the way the law was written.
Right.
And there's a difference between saying, okay, there are certain enforcement laws that are poorly written or misstructured, which I think that one was, that
right.
allowed you to essentially find a crime when none was there,
right?
Versus saying, "We'll restrict your ability to enforce actual laws."
No, I don't. The original bill does go a little too far because I think it restricts them only to on-premise enforcement, which I think probably wouldn't be in the spirit of what we'd be looking at. I mean, enforcement surrounding anything that would be within their purview under the Title 13. Would make sense, but certainly not restricting it only to the establishments themselves, because what happens if you come across an inebriated driver or some situation like that? So I just see the need for that. So I could go either way, I feel like if we don't keep it open, then we might not get the ride along. And I do feel it's an important conversation.
Yeah, I think you get the ride along as long as you ask.
Yeah, right.
I mean, think so?
Oh, yeah.
I would think so.
All right.
After all, we are the committee that handles all of the liquor bills. So
it's true.
Okay, well, on that basis, then we could probably move forward with the ITL. So we'll support that.
Straw poll there.
Yeah.